clinging to a one-point lead over L.A. for that second spot. Here's the draw now as we get underway. It's shot into the Winnipeg zone. And Steve Smith able to step away from a check. Troy Murray tried to label him and missed. And the Hawks shoot it back in. Osborne bumped by Noonan in the corner. Now Cronin ran into Gilbert behind the net. Noonan dug it out, but poke check nicely and alertly by Essenson. He grabs it and hangs on. Now some pushing and shoving in front of the net as Osborne and Noonan had a duel going this entire shift. Meanwhile, there won't be anything happening on the ice with Sean Cronin out there that he won't be in the middle of. And everybody now starting to pull apart.
540 minutes in penalties with one goal.
Yeah, 243 minutes last year. 267 in the American League the year before that. 212 in the American League the year before that. So no stranger to the sin bin. And he's leading the Jets this year with 109 minutes. Now we got a scrap in the corner as Cronin and Grimson are slugging it out. And now Grimson tries to answer after Cronin had an early edge. And they whack away one another in the corner. Now they tumble to the ice. Ready to the right of Essensa. And the draw goes to the corner where Housley sends it around the boards. Brown on the near side. Knocked down by Murray, but he held it in. Now Sutter behind the net. In some traffic. All three Hawk forwards are in the corner. And Larmer gets control of the puck, centered it all alone to Smith. He shoots, he scores! Steve Smith moved in from the far point. Newman got only a piece of that shot trying to block it. Tough chance for the goaltender, and Essensen managed to make the save.
Keith Brown gets a penalty for high sticking along the near board.
He steps over the line, then put it to Steen on the near side. The pass a little behind him, and it's stolen. There's going to be a penalty coming up against Winnipeg, I believe. Now the whistle sounds after a scuffle on the boards. Now Chelios gave Steen a shove. But let's see what the call is going to be here from Lance Roberts. And the Hawks seem to be upset about it. And it looks like the Jets are going to have a two-man advantage. Now Housley back over the Hawk line to Romanuk, far circle. Dropped into the trailer. Newman in a long shot. Housley, they score! And now behind the play, Hartman and Peluso in a scrap. And they're slugging it out, and Peluso has an edge. Flailing away with a left hand. And now Hartman with a couple body shots, but that'll only work in the later rounds to get his defense down. Win in that scrap for Mike Peluso. And Hartman will head to the box.
Lemieux banging and crashing, playing the left wing with Roenick and Larmer. He lets one go. And Roenick trying to get position with Marwa. The stick came up and clipped him. Down goes Roenick, and Marwa will go to the box. If there's any blood, it'll be a five-minute penalty. But it's only 2 minutes. A high-sticking penalty on Marwa. And the Blackhawks will get their power play back.
Here's Troy Murray back into the Chicago zone. Murray tries to center. Kuchera blocked the pass. Murray trying to get it back in a penalty.
He leveled Kuchera as Kuchera was trying to get to a loose puck in the corner. Didn't see him coming. Roberts did, though, and McDermott will get an interference call with 47 seconds left. That went undetected, and Marchman's slashing penalty forces the Jets to the power play.
And a near break for Thomas Steen, but the Jets just offside on the play. Steen had a full head of steam.
Why are they going after Thomas Steen? Steen did nothing. He cut in. They called it offside in a close call. He just went in towards the corner. Didn't shoot the puck or anything.
That's right.
And Chelios gave him a jab, and Graham went after him. Well, they've got to show a lot more control. They've been doing this the last two or three games, the Blackhawks, and just start playing hockey, sticking to scoring goals and playing the game the way it's meant to be played. They might be better off.
Chelios put his stick right in the midsection of Steen. An unwarranted move. Steen said something to him about it, and, you know, and Graham came in there, and the Hawks, the penalties that are questionable calls by the official are magnified because the Hawks hurt themselves so much with foolish penalties. They're a bit fortunate they didn't get one there to be two men short. Here's Roenick over the line. And it poke checked away to Housley. Four skaters aside as Cole and Brown crashing the boards, and a shot is saved by Essensa, and a penalty is going to be called.
Brown's going to get a cross-checking penalty. Brown comes in as the puck is just around the goal line in the corner. And how can you cross-check somebody when you got one hand on your stick? That's amazing to me, but Brown gets a penalty for cross-checking.
Now, Paul McDermott up the left side, avoiding a Lemieux hit as he dumped it in.
McDermott acquired from the Hartford Whalers, adds some muscle to this Winnipeg club. The Winnipeg club has not been a very physical club the last few years, but much more physical this year, the addition of a few rookies and forwards that are aggressive, such as Eagles and McDermott and Osborne and Hartman from Buffalo.
Stu Barnes and Brent Sutter for the draw in the jet zone. Sutter kicked it loose to Peluso, trying to roll it in front, and it came back to him. He scores! Mike Peluso tried to feed Brian Noonan, but the pass hit a skate, came right back to him, and bang! Peluso fired it by Essensa from point-blank range. It's 2-1 Hawks.
Well, Mike Peluso getting as much ice time as anybody tonight, and he gets his third goal of the year. Faceoff was won by Barnes, but he let Sutter get to the puck. Noonan cut off Cronin. Sutter gets it to Peluso. Peluso fans on it, then tries to get it to Noonan. It hits a skate, comes right back to him as Cronin let him go, and Peluso with a long reach was able to get to the loose puck, and he pumped it upstairs. The sensor went down early, and Peluso getting a loose puck and put it in to give the Blackhawks a 2-1 lead.
Now in the Hawk zone, Gilbert kicks it up the boards. And it winds up back at the jet line. Brent Sutter assisting Mike Peluso for his third at 14:47, and now Marchman railroading a jet player in front of the Hawk bench. And Osborne slow to get up, and Marchman's going to get a penalty.
Osborne with his back to Marchman. Marchman cross-checks him from behind. That's a penalty they'll call with regularity. That's a new clamp down by the league this year, hitting from behind.
Up the boards, Cronin. Able to hold it in. McDermott crashes, and then it's knocked away.
Talked about McDermott being a physical winger. He gets in a collision with Conroy, then falls down, and then Hudson gets hit. Troy Murray throwing the shoulder into him.
Hawks make a wholesale change as Newmanen cleared it ahead for Mike Hartman, knocked down by Dirk Graham. Here's Hudson, going to be 2-on-1, has Graham moving. Hudson, center to Graham, and the puck was bouncing around. He couldn't corral it. Murray was right in. Now Graham in the corner, and the jet player is hurt behind the net. And was it Hudson who railroaded the jet player? And Lance Roberts, he didn't know. I don't believe he ever put his arm into the air, but he now comes to survey the scene, and we'll see if there will be a penalty or not. But Marwa slow to get up.
Marwa is still down. He was hit hard by Mike Hudson. Hudson got the elbow up. Hudson circling in behind the net. Marwa, and watch the right elbow. The elbow comes up and fist and just nails Marwa. And Marwa goes down. He's down for the count. He's out cold. And no penalty was called.
Dumping it into the jet zone. Cronin back. He tries to clear it, and now the Hawk player hemmed in along the board. Cronin wants to have a go with Peluso, who is backing away from him. Cronin threw the gloves off, and let's see if Mike Peluso didn't make a good move for his team here.
If this should be a power play, Cronin should get the lone penalty. Cronin with a puck, Peluso with a hit. The stick comes off Peluso's back. Cronin goes at Peluso. For no reason at all, the play continues on. He's trying to goad Peluso into a penalty. Peluso won't bite. Smart play on Peluso's part. Cronin gets the penalty. Good play by Peluso. Good call by Roberts, and the Blackhawks with a 2-1 lead get a penalty called against Cronin. That's something that the Blackhawks have been guilty of the last couple of games.
Leading Hudson to center. Lost it as he came to the line. Eagles the other way. Hudson over the jet line, trying to split the defense and put it into the corner. Lemieux crashing there, jammed it loose to Hudson. Far board to Conroy, to Hudson in the corner. Looking to center, Lemieux a shot, and he hit the side of the goal with that. Lemieux has his own rebound in behind. The jet penalty is over, and a tie-sticking call is going to come here against Housley. He got the lumber up on Lemieux, who tumbled to the ice. Lance Roberts comes to have a look.
Blackhawks go right back to the power play. Phil Housley is going to get a high-sticking penalty. Clipped Lemieux. He went to hook him, and the stick rode up and clipped Lemieux. No blood, so a two-minute high-sticking penalty.
Entering play tonight, here's the draw. Taken by Smith, the long shot, tip, and no goal. It was picked out of midair. Newman, and what a play to save a goal. That was at midair, past Essensa, just ready to go in. Teppo Newman and brilliant hand-eye coordination to keep the Jets in it. Now Graham cutting for the net, centered it. That pass just missed, clicking with Hudson. And the Jets, Elenuk, was stopped at center by Peluso. Then Elenuk. Trying to steal it in the Hawk zone. Got it to Olchek. Shoot! Fell for the save, and he hangs on. And now we're going to have a penalty called against the Hawks. After the whistle sounded, Elenuk was knocked down, and you had to know that the Jets were going to get another power play before this game was over, after the Hawks had had three straight. Late in the third, 2-1, Chicago.
Steve Smith, who scored the game's opening goal in the power play, puts one towards the net about waist high, hits a leg. Hits a sensor, flips up in the air. It's going to go in the net, but out of midair on his backhand, too. I don't know how he made that play. Newman saved the goal. As the Blackhawks won the draw, Smith let it go. The puck bounces first in front of him off of a sensor, and it's going into the net, and a backhand. It might have gotten the post as well as he picked it out of midair and saved the sure goal. Meanwhile, Chelios gets a cross-checking penalty.
20 seconds are left. Here comes Housley. There goes Essensa. Six skaters for Winnipeg as they dump it in. Brent Sutter, or Chelios, is back. It's taken away. Centered Housley. Great chance. Centered it. Here's a chance. They score! Thomas Steen with 7 seconds left. The Winnipeg Jets have tied the game. Thomas Steen in just his second game of the year after having a back problem, paying dividends as he's done so many times in his career here in Winnipeg.
Chelios goes to the corner. He stops. The puck eludes him. Everyone leaves the front of that. Everybody overplays. They're all to the near side. Housley's wide open. He fans on it. Belfour makes the save with the skate. And Steen, left unattended, tucks it in on the backhand. Boy, poor coverage by the Blackhawks. They had possession, coughed it up, and then overplayed it. Got mesmerized by the puck. Got out of position. And Steen with all kinds of time and room. You give Steen time and room like that, he's going to score and force the game into overtime.
Here's the draw. The Jets clear it, and we are going to overtime in the Winnipeg Arena. And here's Carlisle with 4 minutes left. 4 minutes or less remaining. Steen flipped it ahead. Here's a chance for Elena, cutting in center to Shannon.
Trip for the Blackhawks. Well, they had this one under control, only give up four or five shots entirely through the third period, 19 overall, and they end up losing it with a late second goal that tied it. And at 109 of overtime, good outlet pass from Olofsson up the middle to Steen, who got it to Elenuk, and Elenuk got it in to Shannon. The speedy Shannon put it over Belfour. Four beautiful passes by the Jets. Actually five, because Carlisle started it behind his own net.
And now it's 2 wins in 13 games away from home, and certainly much could have had a much better fate tonight.